Today's guest on Degosec Presents is one of the most recognizable local personalities. He is one of the hosts on Morning Pump on Boom Champions 94.1, in addition to which he has hosted several programs on Synergy TV and CCN TV6. He's none other than Mr. Hans Evans. Hans, thank you for joining us today.
No problem.
Okay, Hans, your mom has been a teacher at this school for a number of years. So what was your reaction to the news that you passed for Degosec?
Degosec was actually my second choice, KRC being my first choice. At first, it didn't really affect me. I didn't really have any big thoughts on it. And in primary school, it was more of a matter of me getting ready to move on to the next stage in my life. And then my friends, nobody that went to my primary school came to Degosec, so I knew it was like a new beginning for me. And even at that young age, I kind of noticed that that's what it would be, you know, this new beginning. So I didn't really have any major thoughts on it. But I think she knew before I knew that I was coming to Degosec. And she gave me a card the morning that I had to collect common entrance results at the time. And the card said, she said, you know, I won't tell anybody if you won't tell anybody, and congratulations on passing for Degosec. So when I found out I was coming here, I didn't have any solid thoughts or plan or process. It was just next stage of my life.
Did your teachers or your peers treat you any differently, seeing that you were the son of a teacher here?
Well, truth be told, at first nobody knew, and she didn't teach me till form 3 or 4. So I wasn't treated any differently. I would say to extent some teachers may have been a little bit harder on me based on that, but I don't really think I was treated any differently than any other student in the school.
Tell me about your experience here. Was it a good one, a terrible one?
To me, Diego Martin Secondary, but now Diego Martin Central Secondary, my experience here was good, and my experience here shaped my life in many ways. First of all, you learn to interact with different people from different backgrounds, rich, poor, in between. You have the male-female interaction, and during Degosec, I actually played rugby. I swam a little bit for the school, and I was just around in school, and I always saw it necessary to study and work hard in school. I mean, I've always been the most focused, and most teachers will tell you that I spoke a lot in school, so much so that sometimes teachers would write in my report book, Hans is a good student, but he talks too much, and ironically, that's what I do for a living, I'll talk. So it's kind of funny how that dynamic happened. But Degosec really shaped me. A lot of friendships I made in Degosec are lifetime friendships with individuals. And when you have lifetime friendships, it's not necessarily based on how often you talk to somebody, but I guess where you and that person see each other, and the fact that you all can rely on each other regardless of what happens in your lives. So we actually, I was in 1-1, 2-1, 3-1, and up to this day I still talk to the people that I was in 3-1 with. We have a group on WhatsApp and we talk.
Okay, Hans, when you were in Form 4, you chose subjects to study to be a pilot.
Yeah.
And then after graduating from Degosec, you went to School of Business. What caused the change?
I'll tell you, like I said, everybody. In secondary school, I had a goal and I had a dream. Most people don't ever believe their dreams will come true. My dream was always to be in entertainment. But a part of me was like, that would never really happen. It's a difficult career to get into. And I want to be a pilot. When I finished secondary school, I was too young to do any sort of flight program. So I did CAT, Certified Accountant Technicians course. And while doing that, different doors opened for me in entertainment. I took the opportunities because it was a dream that I always wanted. And that kind of allowed me to be where I am today. And sometimes things happen and you don't notice it's part of God's plan. So, for example, I started behind the scenes in production, but I really wanted to be just simply be a radio announcer and a DJ, which is the smallest part of what I am today. And in visual arts and production where I worked, I was behind the scenes. I was like a camera assistant, so I learned about behind the scenes. And after that, all that was happening when I was doing CAT, opportunities came up for me to, me and the DJ group, I was at the point in time to appear on Party Flavor, or Brian, like how we sounded, put us on overnight. Eventually 98.9 closed down. Our opportunity for a television show came up and I auditioned and got the show. After that show, they called me to work Synergy. Somewhere in between there, ended up, well, before that, I was applying for jobs before I started to work E-Zone with Lisa Wickham. I actually started applying for jobs. This was before Synergy, this was before Party Flavor. I was applying for jobs, and I remember applying for a job in Hilton, and coming down to me and a young lady, and she got the job. Now, at the point I was disappointed I didn't get a job, but looking back at my life, if I had gotten the job, would I have been where I am today? And the truth is no, because again, it's part of this bigger plan. And even if you don't believe in God in the traditional sense, one must acknowledge that the universe has a plan and is working how it has to work. So yeah, that's how I transitioned into, from wanting to be a pilot into what I do now, which is entertainment, because being a pilot was just a goal. I mean, it's something that it's like, yeah, interesting is an interesting career, but it wasn't my dream. And I was encourage young people to follow their dream now, because it's what you love to do. You don't want to reach your work every day and be upset. Life is too short for that, in my opinion, because people go to work every day to make just enough money, most times, to buy a car. They don't have enough money because they're using the money from their job to pay for the car that they're using to get to their job, that they spend, and then they're using that to pay for the house that they live in or the apartment that they're renting. So it's like a cycle of chasing. So in between that cycle of chasing that most people end up in, and no doubt 9 out of 10 people are going to end up in the cycle of chasing and chasing and chasing and not actually enjoying each moment as it comes.
Mm.
You need to be happy with what you're doing. So a lot of times people ask me if, you know, if any day is like a hard day, and I don't have hard days, because growing up, that's what I dreamt of. And when you think about it, there's somebody out there who is like, yeah boy, when I get older, I want to know what Hans is doing. And because there's that person out there, it drives me even more, because I was in that position, and at that position, what people say is, boy, I would do almost anything to get that and to keep that. And when you're in the position, when you get whatever job, you just don't have that dedication because you don't love it. You have no passion. And if you're doing something without passion, then might as well not do it. Because there's so much more to life than just a job and just making money. And you look at the people that are successful, in my opinion, the most successful people are doing things that they love, doing things that they are happy with. And to me, that's success. Not $1 million, just being able to live and survive off of something that you love, whether it's painting, whether it is, I don't know, exercising, whether it's playing video games. If you could make money for something you love, that's the best place for you to be.
Okay, can you trace where the dream came from? Were you influenced when you were younger by any entertainer?
Growing up, it was Alicia the Duchess, O'Brien Haynes, Wendell Constantine, to a lesser extent, Jason Williams, Tamara Williams, who I used to listen to on 98.9. And when I first decided I wanted to do this entertainment thing was when I first started to listen to dancehall music. Kind of funny. When my friends who also one day was like, but he was in a lower form after because he went to junior secondary first. Karen Georgia, he had a dancehall cassette and I was listening to the cassette and I was like, hey, I'm hearing dancehall music and hearing the music of the urban music and getting in tune with that urban music kind of switched me into this whole wanting to be in entertainment. The decent house that, well, this is when Synergy TV opened, I knew from the day that that channel premiered at one point in time I was going to be there. Like I knew it, like I was like, yeah, I want to be there, I want to be part of this some way, somehow. And when the opportunity came, I took it. And I used to go the extra distance. I used to, again, I was sleepless nights. I used to work really hard when I was at Synergy producing. A lot of people don't know that's not produced Synergy Superstar, Synergy Supermodel music videos. When I was at Synergy, the scene which I also hosted. So it's like, you just take the opportunities, and at different points, the goal changes. But the initial goal, the initial thought of me wanting to be in entertainment came from hearing the music, seeing other people do it, and seeing that it was a possibility. And today, again, I say anything is possible for anybody. It could be anything. The world is one global village. You live in a global village.
Mm.
So it's possible.
Why do you think you're so popular? What is it that makes you so unique that people would want hands hosting an event?
Because I'm me. I'm not apologetic about who I am, where I'm from, where I grew up. I understand my circumstances, not the same as everybody's circumstance. And I care about this craft. I look at my peers in entertainment, some things that I did, some people never even think about doing, going for vocal training to help you as a better announcer, going for acting lessons and training to make you a better radio announcer, television presenter, because technically that's what you're doing every time the camera comes on, you're acting. Simple things like going the extra mile, going the extra distance. My passion and love, I would say, has taken me because people see that and they feel that. They know the difference. People could tell the difference between somebody who's doing something just because and then somebody who's doing something that they love. And I think, going back to this point I raised earlier, the passion is what sets me apart and the willingness to learn. I always wanted to learn and I always wanted to learn one. Be better. How can I be better? And I have a kind of relationship with people on camera and I feel it. And I feel it because I experienced it already. When I went to Jamaica, there's this announcer called Winfrey Williams, so I watch little videos of him interviewing artists. And I felt like I knew him when I saw him and I nearly went up to him to talk to him. But then I caught myself and I was like, but I already know him, so I can't go up to him and talk to him. And similarly, when people see me on TV, they feel like they know me. When people listen to me on radio, they feel like they know me. And because I give myself, because you've given me your time, so I give myself. And when you give yourself, people feel like they know you. So a lot of times people feel like they know their favorite entertainer. They feel like they know Bungie, the Marshall, the Destro, the Fan. They feel like they know them and they could walk up to them and speak to them. And I understand that. So I give my all to it. And I think because I give my all and I give me, and there's a level of love and passion for it, people see that and they feel that. So that's why there's a level of connectivity with me and my audience. Because my audience is not necessarily, they're not always my peers. They're not people who went to the same school as me. They're not people, sometimes they may have gone, I went to a so-called prestige school. what I think the USAC is a prestige school, in my opinion, but that's another conversation.
Mm.
Or some people who may have never gone to school, it's because you're there with them and you're giving them you. And anything you're doing, you have to give of yourself if you want to be successful.
Okay, so Hans, you also have your own production company. What sort of things do you guys do?
We do television shows, music videos, commercials. Recent works is in security programs, Southern Wholesale Stores Limited. Second Stage is a television series that we did. Anatomy is a television series that we did. I also produce a lot of the shows that I work on now, and that people see me hosting. So for example, Promenade Come Down, a lot of people don't know this, but they're actually my ideas that I'm manifesting. So Promenade Come Down is an idea I went to CCMTV6 with, not as a production company, but as an individual. And I work behind the scenes as well as in front of the scenes of that program. So to answer the question, I just saw the work we do in terms of on-time productions and me working behind the scenes.
I've seen you perform on stage. You told me you're in an upcoming movie. Is the Soka star next?
Not necessarily. My main thing is hosting, producing. I'm what could be considered an entertainment personality. And I don't want to confuse people too much in terms of my career. Even if I do sing a soca, it is not to be a soca artist. Meaning that if I sing a soca song, it will be a DJ singing or a host, radio announcer, doing a soca song. Meaning, I'm not going to try to compete with the artist because people don't really have an unfair advantage, as you know, when they sing songs. So it's not that that's part of the plan, but if I decide to do it, I want people to say he said he wouldn't do it and he did it. And if I do sing a soca and I do end up getting bookings, I'm not going to sacrifice my hosting jobs, because that's who I am, that's where my heart is, and that's where my real passion is. My passion is not to be a singer.
Okay, Hans, what else is there for you to accomplish?
To me, being recognized as a host internationally is something I would still like to accomplish. I'd like to help more people in terms of the next big host. I would like to inspire more, learn more, teach more, contribute more. Do more television shows. Eventually one day become the CEO of a television station, maybe one day own a television station, maybe be a politician someday. It's whatever is part of the bigger plan. And there are things that I want to achieve, but whatever is the plan for me, it will reveal itself over time in different ways, and there'll be a natural progression to what it is. So my personal plans and what I personally want to achieve are those things that I mentioned before. But there's the understanding of, if it's not part of the plan, it's just not part of the plan.
Okay, I heard that you've gone back to your business studies.
Yes, I have.
What's the purpose of doing that?
Again, sometimes it's part of the plan. And my situation is this. I started CAT, I finished CAT. I started ACCA, I didn't finish ACCA. I had 4 more papers to do. I have 3 more papers to do. And I went back to ACCA because, one, it's something that I didn't complete in life. 2, as an entertainment personality, I am planning for the next stage in my life. a next stage in my life, I feel like it's going to point me in the direction of being a CEO and influencing more local content across the world on television. Because our main television stations, whilst they have local content, CCN TV has a nice amount of local content, but I just feel like more could be done and more of us as a people, and not just a people of Trinidad and Tobago, but Caribbean people, more of us could be on TV and we should be seeing more of us on television rather than people that live a different life in a different part of the world and have different experiences, because our experiences are our experiences, and if we see our experiences, we'll be able to relate our experiences. And I think with a professional accounting qualification and my experience in entertainment, I'll be able to successfully apply for a position, and it would make sense to hire me.
Okay, Hans, so a lot of young people are listening to you on the radio, they're seeing you on TV, and they want to be like you. What advice do you have for them?
Be like yourself, but you don't want to be like me. Be like you. Want to be like you. One day, profession, I guess, that I have, come and take my job. Nah, I'm not saying that just because. I'm saying that to let you all know it's possible. Come and take my job. But to take my job, you have to work as hard as I work, or harder than I work. So come and take my job. I don't believe in luck. Luck, what people call luck, is opportunity meets preparedness. When the opportunity arises, whatever it is in life that you want to do, you have to be prepared. So be prepared for when that opportunity opens up.
Thanks for joining us today.
No problem. Thank you, Mr. Stanford. Right. And thank you to Diego Martin Central Secondary for helping mold me into the person that I am today.